Is the FRM exam really difficult? Hi friends, this is Ganesh Nayak. I help finance professionals and students to excel in their career and become a better version of themselves through a lot of trainings and development and mentoring. And I also help FRM and CFA students to clear their exam in the first attempt. Now, this question, whether the FRM exam is difficult or how difficult is the FRM exam, I constantly get this question. So I'm just creating a small video so to address that query for the students so that they can go and appear for the exam in a better way. Okay. Now, the answer to this question is yes, the exam is difficult. Okay. Now, if you're going to be comparing this exam, I'm talking about Indian students now. If you're going to be comparing this exam with your college students, college exam, graduation exam, college exam, or your MBA college exams, then definitely this is way tougher. Okay. A lot of students have given the exam which is related to IIBF, which is Indian Banking Institute's exam. So comparing that also, FRM is a lot more tougher. Okay. The reason it is tough, okay, the first point being the content of the exam is not very straightforward. That means the content of the exam involves, gives you an idea about statistics, it gives you an idea about the financial market, it also gives you an idea about the risk management part of the bank, the level one. When you go to level two, okay, there are specific books tackling or talking about the risk that a bank face, for example, market risk, credit risk, operation risk. So that is the basic trend that we see. Okay. Now, this is a, so the content is also very good. The second point being, this is a global certification. So if you're looking at NISM certifications or IIBF examinations, okay, the competition over here is going to be at the global scale. So you will find yourself competing with students from China, students from US, who are also very actively preparing for the FRM exam. You'll see a lot of Chinese students clearing the exam also. So the competition is with them, okay? And the third important point is the exam is not based on percentage. It is based on percentile, which essentially means that you have to be better than the others. Okay, I'll give you an example. So suppose there is a 20 question that is going to come from your first book, which is Foundation of Risk Management. Okay, out of the 20 question, if the exam paper is tough, the exam overall was tough, then solving and clearing 10 questions or 11 questions, you would be in the top 25 percentile students who appeared for the exam in that book. Okay, that essentially means you are in the top. Why? Because only by solving 11 questions, because other people could not solve, because the exam was tough. Okay, but think about this: if the exam is easy and everybody is able to solve and get the answer, then you might have to solve 16, 17 questions to be in the top 25 percentile of the students. Okay. Now, if you want to clear this exam, okay, ideally in all the books, book one, book two, book three, book four, you should be in the top 50 percentile people. That means you should be better than the 50% of the janta who is going to give the exam. Okay, in each book, that is a good way to clear the exam. But in terms of the difficulty, the percentile situation makes it slightly tricky because even if you have solved a lot of questions, you might not clear because the paper was easy and everybody was able to solve. So your competition is with the global scale and that too on a relative basis. That means that too on a percentile basis. Okay. The next point being, when you get the end into the exam, there are 100 questions which you will get for the level one exam and 80 questions for level two exam. 100 question is primarily going to come jumbled, so there'll be no section-wise bifurcation that this is what you're going to get. Okay, that is what makes the exam slightly tough. Okay, now if the exam is tough, why should you go for this exam? Okay, see, think about this. This is tough, hence not many people are able to clear the exam, and hence you find the value of the certification in the industry, not only in India but outside India also. Okay, so when you look at that, the recognition, the gains that you get in terms of monetary benefit, then the non-monetary benefit that you get by doing the certification is very, very huge. In the future, okay, you have to think it from this perspective. In the future, when you want to go abroad or when you get an opportunity to work abroad, this certification will help you. So even though the exam is tough, it is actually good for you because when you clear the exam, you'll immediately see the benefit because not many people have cleared it. So you will be one of them to clear the exam. And this is the future of risk management in India. And also this exam is going to be treated as an entry level when you look at the 7 year, 10 year down the line, entry level roles will be starting out with the interviews will get scheduled only if you have cleared FRM level one. That is what I see in the industry going on. Okay. So even though the exam is tough, you should appear for the exam, prepare properly for the exam, read the content and then pay to the institute. That is what I recommend to all the students, and then go for the exam confidently and clear the exam. Okay. I have seen students clearing the exam in the first attempt. So that is not difficult. Okay. I've seen college graduates who are still in their college have cleared the exam in first attempt. Only thing is you have to prepare properly. You have to prepare with a plan. Okay. And also consistently. You cannot just go and give the exam. You cannot just say that I'll prepare 1 month before the exam. That is not how the exam is going to get cleared. You'll have to prepare at least 5-6 months properly to appear and clear the exam in the first attempt. Okay. So I hope this helps the query of whether the exam is tough or not, what all factors makes it tough, and how you should look at the exam.